Hi, I'm Lindsay Jones, voice of RWBY on the animated show, RWBY. Autodesk Maya is an important tool in the creation of our show. It's the primary software used in many of our pipelines, including modeling, rigging, animating, lighting, rendering, and visual effects. Today, Rooster Teeth rigging artist Gio Coutinho will be showing us how she uses Maya for character rigging.
In this video, I'll be walking through very simple skinning tips which have helped me improve the quality of my rigs. I'll start off by selecting my already bound mesh and going into the Paint Skin Weights tool, where I will flood all of my influences over to the temp clavicle bind. By doing this, I'll be starting the weighting process completely from scratch rather than fighting against Maya's default skinning. Once that's done, I'll select my arm joint and key it at two different positions. This will allow me to scrub through the animation slider and see what the skinning will look like in motion. Go back into your mesh and go into vertex mode, making sure that joint selections are disabled. What you'll want to do is select all of the verts where you want your arm influence to begin, including the elbow, the hand, and the fingers. And once that's done, you'll go back into Paint Skin Weights tool, and you'll be taking the weights which are now on the clavicle, which is the parent, and you'll be giving it to the arm, which is the child. You can scrub through the animation slider, and you'll see how rough that is. So you'll want to go back in and make a new selection in order to smooth out that weighting. So if you scrub through and you change your operation to smooth, you'll be able to do that. But a very important step in this process is to make sure that you lock all of your influences except for the arm and the clavicle. You want to be dealing only with the parent and the child and no other joints. Otherwise, Maya might decide to assign weights to joints which are completely irrelevant in this case. So once all of those other influences are locked and your operation is set to smooth, you can flood that and you can immediately see the results that you'll get. It seems like my selection was a little bit too big, so I'll go back into those verts and back into the Paint Skin Weights tool. And I want to remove those weights from the arm and give them back to the clavicle. So I'll go to Replace and set the value to 0. And there you have it. Now that still needs a little bit more smoothing. So I'll go back in, make more selections, and smooth that out as much as I need to, until I think it looks good. Once I reach the point where I'm happy with it, I'll go back to my arm joint, and I'll delete those keys. And then I'll move on to my elbow joint. And once more, the most important step in this is to make sure that only the parent and the child that you're dealing with are the influences that are unlocked. And in this case, the parent is the arm and the child is the elbow. So you want to make sure that your clavicle is locked. And once more, what you'll be doing is taking from the parent and giving to the child. You can scrub through and see that rough animation and smooth it out. Repeat with the wrist. You will want to lock the arm and unlock the wrist and give from the parent to the child. And then smooth as much as you need in order to make that appealing. This is a pretty simple skinning technique, which I wish I had learned a little bit sooner in my rigging career. It helps you avoid stray influences, while also giving you a really good base to work on. Even if it doesn't get you all the way through, you can always go back in and polish any influences that you think might look a little bit off. If you have any questions, please feel free to let me know. I'll be happy to answer them. Thank you for watching.